Everyone, this is Sivalakshmi Pannasalvam, working as an assistant professor in EC department at RMK College of Engineering and Technology. In today's session, we are going to see about digital signals. So what's all about? In digital signal, we discretize both time and magnitude axis. For explanation purpose, I have taken this graph. See, with having your axis shown, you can identify what type of signal I'm going to discuss first. Looking at the axis of time, you can say that I've discretized into 5 intervals of time durations, and that too equal interval of time duration. This general expression for defining your equal interval of time duration, we call it as a del of t, which is equal to tn minus t of n minus 1. So, with this, I can say that I'm going to speak about discrete time signal having the collected data to be 9 degrees Celsius of temperature, 38 degrees, 24 degrees Celsius of temperature, 15 degrees Celsius of temperatures, and 50 degrees Celsius of temperature for different time intervals. So, with this available 5 data, I'm going to plot my graph, and I have done it for you. And now you can see it look like this. Still, it is a DTS signal. So the same, if I want to make it available as a digital signal now, you know that you can make it, but before that you have to discretize your magnitude axis. Here the magnitude axis is nothing but speaking about your temperature. So you have to fix certain values of temperature as a fixed number of levels so that the other values are not allowed. So, for that case, I'm introducing 3 different temperatures in between my lower value and my higher value. Right now, I'm going to have, for the digital signal, I'm going to have these values of temperature to be the permissible value of temperature, like 0 degrees Celsius, 15 degrees Celsius, 30 degrees Celsius, and 45 degrees Celsius. And 50 degrees Celsius. So if this is going to be the case now, say suppose right now I have to convert it into my digital signal. So what I'll do is, assuming, say suppose at time t1 seconds, what is the observed data I have got in my hand? At time t1 second, my temperature actually is 9 degrees Celsius. When I am representing with a digital signal now, then it has to be rounded off to either, because 9 degrees Celsius lies in between 0 and 15 degrees Celsius, wherein in my fixed levels it is not there. So it won't show. My digital signal won't show the value 9 degrees Celsius of temperature. It will show either the value of 0 degrees Celsius or 15 degrees Celsius. So we have to round it off to the lowest range of value so that it would so that we can avoid errors always. So what will be your temperature at time t1 seconds now? It would be rounded off to 0 degrees Celsius so that we can avoid errors. And similarly, coming for the next set of value, what is the temperature during time at time 2 second? It is 38 degrees Celsius. Look into the graph. It lies between 45 degrees Celsius and 30 degrees Celsius, whereas these are the 2 permissible temperature values. So I have to round it off to the lowest value so that I can minimize my error. So now in your digital signals at time 2 seconds, my temperature would be showing 30 degrees Celsius. Similarly, for time 3 seconds, my value 24 degrees Celsius, actual value lies in between my 30 degrees Celsius and 15 degrees Celsius. So it will take the least value. So in my digital signal, the temperature at time t3 second is 15 degrees Celsius. Similarly for t4, whereas t4 the actual value is 15 degrees Celsius. So in my digital, it is permissible. So it will show it as such. So at time t5 seconds, what is my temperature? 50 degrees Celsius, wherein my allowed and permissible value of temperature, the maximum value of temperature I assumed in my digital signal to be 45 degrees Celsius, 0 to 45, not 50. So even if I'm going to have any higher value of temperature, now it will be rounded off to the lowest value of temperature, that is my 45 degrees Celsius. So these are the values. The same set of values would be represented as like this in your discrete time signals and digital signals. So this is what all about. So remember, if you have to discretize your magnitude axis, for explanation purpose, I have taken your physical quantity to be temperature, wherein in your electrical and electronics, you will go for the same explanation we could correlate with your voltage or current. You have to fix your voltages always in your ICs for digital devices. We'll have a maximum value of 5 volts and a minimum value of 0 volts. So within that, we have to fix some levels. Only those levels would be represented in your digital signals. Other than that, it won't show or it won't consider. So this is what I have projected again. So DTS can have, discrete time signal can have any value of temperature between 0 to 50 degrees Celsius. Whereas digital signals can have the temperature value equal to fixed value only. So I hope with this general explanation, you would have understood what is your digital signals, how we are coming out with a raw data of information into a digital signal. So now let us consider one more example with having my digital signal with two fixed levels of voltages, 0 and 5 volts. So if that is the case, now if I try to plot it in a graph, I'll end up like this. See, for an example, if my input signal right now at this moment, if it's going to be 2 volts at time t 1 second, now, so this is how it'll appear. Because I've discretized, I'm considering this example to be a digital signal. So I've discretized both my time axis as well as my magnitude axis, which speaks about the voltage. So in this case, remember also I have set the value to be 0 volts and 5 volts. If that is the case, now what will happen to my input signal? My actual input signal is 2 volts, whereas in your digital signal it will be reduced to either of these two values. So it's obvious that always to the lowest range value of voltage. So now, right now, in my digital signal, what will be the signal value? V of t1 is equal to 0 volts, but an error has happened because my actual input signal is 2 volts, but it has to be reciprocated even in my digital signal, wherein what has happened now, it has been reduced into 0 volts, which is not acceptable by the sender. So I can say or refer that voltage difference to be a error voltage. So here the error voltage is equal to 2 volts. So as to reduce this error, we have to increase the number of levels we have assumed. Earlier we have assumed 0 and 5 volts. Instead, we would increase the levels to 4 levels. Say suppose, what will happen? Assuming it as a case 2. So right now I want to increase it to 4 levels. So what will happen? The maximum voltage to be 5. So 5 voltage divided by 4 intervals of voltage. Now what will happen? So I'll end up with 1.25 volts. So again, you will have a signal fixed voltage levels to be 1.25 volts, 2.5 volts, 3.75 volts and 5 volts. So now consider the same case. If my input signal right now having this case as a criteria, what will happen? Input signal is 2 volts, which is lying between 1.25 and 2.5. So what will happen now? It's obvious that it will take, we have to round it off to the lowest value in your digital signal. So right now, what is my digital signal voltage value? V of T1 is equal to 1.25 volts. So still I have a error voltage to be 0.75 volts. But look at the error voltage difference for the case 1, and for the case 2. So in your case 1, the error voltage is 2 volts, wherein in your case 2, the error voltage is reduced. So still it is understood that we have to increase our levels of voltage. So again I'll go for the case 3, increasing the levels from 4 to 5. So 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1 volt. So I'll have 5 different levels of voltages, like 1 volt, 2 volt, 3 volts, 4 volts and 5 volts. If having this as a case, right now I'll consider my input signal. What will happen to the input signal? Is it being produced as such or still we have an error? So my input signal is 2 volts. 2 volts, which is a permissible voltage in this case. So we will have the digital signal voltage to be V of T1 is equal to 2 volts, and here the error voltage is 0. So this is how we can reduce the error in a signal, and that too specifically in your digital signal. So I hope with this simple explanation you would have understood the digital signal concept and also how to avoid errors. In our next video, we will see about the need for digital signals. In other words, the advantages of digital signals over analog signals. Thank you. Thanks for watching.